Welcome to Advocates for Justice Legal Services. I'm Coach Neighbors here, keeping it real 100. In today's video, I'm going to review the changes made to the pro se criminal offense lawsuit package. I will open up the lawsuit package and show you the documents you will receive when you invest in this package. We're going to review the criminal jurisdiction limitations before we get started working, highlighting the due process rights or the Fifth Amendment of state citizens. And that we're talking the Constitution here. In my non-conventional program, the goal is to hold these players accountable for the process they're putting you through. Not to lie. So you want to hold them accountable for the process that the illegal process that they're putting you through. And that's pretty much how we do this. The demand for sanctions will cause the prosecutor to have to make a decision. If they want to hire an attorney, they have to hire an attorney, and they have to do all this stuff. Here's the cake of that demand for sanctions. If the demand for sanctions is granted or stuck in the face and a judge has to rule on it, well, you think the judge is going to grant it? Probably not. You think the judge is going to grant the TRO to block the state court from receiving federal funding as long as they're violating your rights? Probably not, but that's the beauty of this. Here's the thing. Until you figure out how to make these fools be fair, you got shit for the program, you might lock yourself in their jail. Okay, because that's what it's going down to. Now, you also have a 42 U.S.C. 1983 civil rights lawsuit package to file in federal court against state players. But that's after you bust in court. Well, that's not true. You absolutely can, and there's no difference between doing that than there is between filing Supreme Court case law in state or federal. Now, I can't file state and federal, that's going the wrong way. And we've had a couple attorneys try that because they had a hard time getting off underneath the punches that were sticking in their face. These criminal defense strategies can help you stay out of prison or out of jail as long as there's no injured party and no damage to property. That's pretty much the key in using the strategies that I put together here for you. If there's no injured party and no damaged property, then you need to get this package and stick it in their face. The prosecutor has a lot on the line facing your challenge because if the prosecutor lose your challenge, all the government's prior convictions will be called out for judicial review. And that's the same concept behind attacking the judge. If it goes long enough to where it looks like the judge has to defend him or herself, then other people are going to be calling, you see how that works. The prosecutor does not have an injured party, and therefore the court lacks jurisdiction. So that's that, the long and short of it. Could it be more simple than that? This lawsuit package has been upgraded to include the new TRO to block the state from receiving federal funding. And then when you file your lawsuit in federal court, I would also file in your case in federal court. Now, the idea here is, you know, they ain't gonna wanna help these fools because they're all making bank from stealing your shit. So the idea here is if the judge refuses to block the state from receiving federal funding, well, now you need to sue the judge. File a claim against the judge. Is it known as a claim against the judge for violating your due process and helping his friends? The idea here is to never have to answer to their stuff. Okay, you want to trump them and always make them come answer to you. And so that's what you're going to do here. If the judge refuses to follow the law and grant the TRO, then you need to do something about it. Anytime the judge dismisses your stuff or violates you need to do something about it. I have plenty of videos on demand and reconsideration, how to control the judge, how to block the eviction process. I have videos on all of that stuff. And I think from the communication from a lot of people, people aren't spending a lot of time watching them. So you need to go and watch that. The demand for sanctions also challenges court jurisdiction and addresses the fact that the government cannot be an injured party. The government cannot be an injured party. That's total BS. And I provide the case law and the court decisions to verify the facts stated. And so here's something that's interesting. And, you know, it all goes back to, could it be that simple? Criminal jurisdiction is derived from the statute. Yep, criminal jurisdiction is derived from the statute. Now, we already talked earlier in other videos, the statutes are not valid laws. The problem with that is statutes are not valid laws, as they do not contain the three elements necessary to be considered a valid law. I know everybody thinks, what are those elements? I go over them. I'm not going to make you go look them up. I'm just going to tell you right now. An acting clause, a title, and a body. Those are the three things that your state constitution mandates must be present for something to be a valid law. And so none of those things are present in their statutes and codes. Their whole criminal crap is just that. Could you imagine all the people that are locked up for stupid shit if they knew? Well, we're getting out there now and people are going to find that package. I'm going to screen share the lawsuit package and just show you the document that you're going to get. Now, I'm not going to spend a lot of time on the documents because I did that in the instructional video. So if you want to see what the documents look like or whatever, you can go over and watch it in the instructional video. I'm just going to show you what you're getting. When you get the package, it's going to be in a zip file. When you click on it, this is what you'll see, and you'll have to click on it again. And open up all the documents that you have in it. Now, whenever you see a zip file like this, that means that this is a complete different package that's been added to the package. So in order to learn how to deploy this, you need to watch the instructional video for the inventory motion for summary judgment. That's what that is. And this one here, this is the 42 USC 1983 for traffic lawsuit. This is for statute, so you're going to use that for whatever statute they're sticking it in your face. So you can see here the United States Affidavit of State Citizenship and the diplomatic immunity. This is the instructions on how to do this so that you can reclaim your state citizenship. This is the new document to recuse the judge, the inventory demand for sanctions against the prosecutor. And this is the sanctions challenging jurisdiction. And this is the default motion because the prosecutor is not going to be able to respond to what you're sticking in their face. Now, this ring strategy is pretty much for, we put this together for a foreclosure offense. I put it in here so people can see the steps that other people are going through. So if you're getting stuck, then you might check out the steps that these people are going through to see if you should be doing some of those steps. This is a sanction motion for a hearing request. I just do this in here to turn the heat up on their ass. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 documents that you get there. And the inventory motion for summary judgment has 2 documents, so that's 10. And then this is the lawsuit package. And so you're getting like 17 documents in this package, and I guarantee you won't. You're not going to need to use all of them. I just put them in there because this is my premium package to stop criminal prosecutions, and I want to make sure that everything is in there that people may need. Now, the strategy here is to force the prosecutor to drop the criminal case before you file your lawsuit in federal court. Now you will be able to demand the federal court to order settlement hearings because if they dropped the case on a state level, then they knew they were messing with you and they're trying to get out the back door. So there's no need to go through all that rigmarole in federal court. You file your lawsuit and then you add the documentation from the state court to show that the case was dismissed, which is your evidence to verify that they were violating your due process and stuff. Now, the fact the prosecutor dismissed the case proves you were being violated. It's plain, keep it simple. This lawsuit package will allow you to take control without an attorney in your face or working to get you that wonderful deal that they offer people in criminal court. Now, this new non-conventional criminal offense lawsuit package has the firepower and deadly strategy you need to stop being a defendant. Now, if anything I said here catches your attention, if you're in this situation, you need to get over to my website at winningcourtnow.com and check out this lawsuit package that's posted on there. And you also may go to my YouTube channel, and I'll leave links in the description to both of these. You can go to my YouTube channel and watch the instructional video. So you'll have an idea of everything that you need to do to get this working. Thank you guys for the value of sharing your time. I'll see you in the next video. Oh, don't forget to subscribe, ring that bell, and click on those ads so I can get paid for bringing this free fire to the table.